हेलो एवरीवन, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद एक्सरसाइज 14.5 क्वेश्चन नंबर 6। सो इट सेज यू हैव टू ड्रॉ एनी सर्कल विद सेंटर सी एंड रेडियस 3.4 सेंटीमीटर। सो वी विल डू स्टेप बाय स्टेप हियर। ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सेंटर इज सी एंड रेडियस इज गिवन टू बी 3.4 सेंटीमीटर। सो वी विल ओपन आवर कंपास विद द लेंथ 3.4 सेंटीमीटर लाइक दिस। So, we'll first of all mark a circle, center of the circle. This is point C. And now what we need to do, we have to draw a circle with this radius 3.4 centimeter. So, here I have drawn a circle with radius 3.4 centimeter. So, radius was given, so I can mark here the radius. Center was C, so I can mark it as CD. This is 3.4 centimeter. Now the center of the circle is C and the radius is 3.4 centimeter. Now next, what is told in the question? You have to draw any chord AB. What is the chord of a circle? It is the line segment joining any two points on the circle. So anywhere here or here or here, anywhere we can draw the chord of the circle AB. Okay, so I am going to draw the chord of the circle here. Okay, let's make it slanting now. This is, I have drawn any chord. You can take any chord AB. So I have taken this chord AB. Now, after drawing the chord, what we need to do? We have to construct perpendicular bisector of this AB. Now, here, this is the line segment AB, right? And you have to draw its perpendicular bisector. So, again, this is the length. So, to draw its perpendicular bisector, what we need to do? So, just check. I'm going to highlight this. Again, students, make sure you are not going to use the colored pens, right? I'm going to do it for your convenience only. So here, just check, this is the line segment. Now this is the tilted one. This is AB, the line segment for which we have to draw the perpendicular bisector. So again, what will we do? As usual, we will open our compass more than half of this line segment. So again, just check. I'm going to open it more so that my curves should be outside the circle. It will be for the convenience only, so that our construction should look neat and clean. Okay, I'm going to open it more so that my two arcs should be outside the circle. That's why I have opened it more. Students, if your arcs cuts inside the circle somewhere here or here, please don't panic. It can be done. It can be inside the circle also. Because if I will open my compass a bit less, the arcs will cut here only, right? Here. Somewhere inside the circle. But I am going to open my compass with more length so that my work should be neat. So, first arc I have cut it here. So, you can check, this was the line segment. Here is our line segment AB. So, one arc should be above the line segment AB and other should be below. It should be below like this. At this point, somewhere here, from point B, like this. Now, next two arcs we have to draw from another end point of this line segment, that is the point A. So, from point A, it should cut the first arc. So, here these are the two points where the two arcs cut each other. So next we have to join these two points, right? So let's join these. So just check. I have not done it knowingly, but you have to check. Examine whether it passes through the point center C. So just check. We have drawn our perpendicular bisector and automatically it has passed through the center C, right? So students, from here you can see we have drawn any circle and I have drawn any random chord of the circle. So, if you will draw the perpendicular bisector of that chord, it will definitely pass through the center C. So, here you have to write down the answer also. This we have done question number 6 here. So, you will write down, you have to examine if it passes through the center C. So, you will write down your answer, yes. Perpendicular bisector of the chord AB So here we will write down that yes, perpendicular bisector of chord AB passes through the center C. Now next is question number 7. You have to repeat the question number 6 if AB happens to be a diameter. So in question number 6, we have taken AB as any random chord of the circle. Now in question number 7, we have to, knowingly we have to take AB as the diameter. So let's do. Now let's check for question number 7. I have drawn a circle with radius 3.4 cm and I have drawn chord AB as its diameter. You already know that chord diameter is what? Diameter is the longest chord of the circle. So now we have not drawn any ordinary chord. We have taken it as diameter for question number 7. So now again what we need to do? We have to draw perpendicular bisector of AB. So again we'll open our compass more than half of this line segment AB and we have to draw two arcs, one below the line segment AB. This is the line segment AB, right? So two arcs should be below and two arcs should be above the line segment AB, right? And again I'm telling you students, your arcs can cut inside the circle also. If you will open your compass with small length, so that is also okay, don't panic. So now we are going to draw the perpendicular bisector. We are going to join these two points. So again you can check the perpendicular bisector of the diameter AB also passes through the center C, right? So again you can write down, yes, it passes through the center C. What is that? It is the perpendicular bisector of chord diameter AB here. Now the chord happens to be the diameter. So we'll write down, yes, it passes through the center C, right? So students, here you can check that the diameter and any whenever you will draw the center perpendicular bisector of any chord of any circle, it will definitely pass through the center of the circle. So this is the thing to remember. You have checked it randomly also. You have checked it practically. Whenever you will draw any perpendicular bisector of any chord of any circle, it will definitely pass through the center of the circle. So this was all about question number 6 and question number 7. Thank you and have a nice day.